Hello friend, welcome to my channel. Here today I am going to discuss about disk structure. Okay friend, so friend, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and like and comment on this video. Okay friends, so let's start disk structure. Okay, now why we are using disk? Okay, as we know, there are two type of a storage device in a CPU. First one is a primary storage device and second one is secondary storage device. So disks come into a secondary storage device. Okay, the primary storage devices are like cache memory, RAM and ROM. Okay, so disks come in a secondary storage device. Why we use secondary storage device? When we want to store a large amount of data, we need some permanent storage device. Okay, large amount of data for a long time. Okay, so this is why we use secondary storage device. The example of secondary storage device is disk. Okay, now let's start discussing about the structure of disk. Okay, here I'll draw a diagram about a disk. Here you see I have divided it into a multiple circle. Okay, so suppose this is a disk, this first circle and this second circle, this second third circle, these all are known as track. Okay, so how many tracks in a disk? Here in this example, here is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this circle is known as track. Okay, okay, now let's move towards sector. Now what is sector? Now each track is divided into multiple sector in this way. Okay, so here total number of track, first we write total number of track equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4. Now we want to know about total number of sector. Okay, so here number of track are 4 and number of sector per track. Here suppose we are taking the outermost track, this one. So here 1, this is a sector. This part is a one sector, this is second sector, this is third, this is fourth and this is 5. In this way, this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So total number of a sector per track is 5. This is same for every track. So number of tracks are 4 and total number of sector per track is 5. Similarly, we can see in second track, this is, suppose this is first track, I'll assign this as a first track, this is second track, this is third track, this is fourth track. Okay, so number one track have 5 sector, number two have again 5 sector, number three track have 5 sector. So each track have a constant number of sector. Okay, so this is the way the disk is divided into track and sector. Now there is another term also which is known as platter. Okay, so this type, this upper part is known as platter. Here we can write here in this way, PLA platter. Okay, so what is platter? Platter is the upper part which is associated with read write head. When we want to read the data from a disk, we need a read write head which read data from platter. This is upper part is known as platter. Okay, so you now know about track, platters and sector. Okay, now one term is also there, that is block. This is one block, the data stored per sector. Okay, so here this in this way, this is also known as block, the data stored per sector. Suppose I'll draw a diagram for a block. Here I'll take this is as a block, okay. Okay, each block is again divided into multiple parts in this way. This where we store data, so this is known as offset. Okay, this is offset, and the size of this block is 512 bytes. Okay, the starting offset value is 0 and the last one is 511. Now this is a block. Each block is divided into multiple offset and data stored here. So this is where the data stored in a sector. This is a track. The part in which the track is divided is known as sector. The whole part is known as platter, where the read write head is associated, and the block. Okay, so we just go through four terms. Now let's take an example for it. Here is a question about the hard disk. So the question is, the following data refer to a hard disk. Okay, this is the data which is about hard disk. So number of track per site is 600. Here suppose this is a hard disk, okay, in this way and so on. These are the track. So the number of track is 600. So track is equal to 600, but here we see the number of sites equals to 2, means we can store a data in both side. Okay, so how we calculate total number of track? So we just multiply 600 by 2, which is equal to 1200. Okay, now it tell number of byte per sector. Okay, so this is the sector. The track is divided into multiple sector. This is sector 1, this is sector 2. Okay, so the number of byte per sector is 512, and storage capacity in byte is this one. So the whole data stored in a hard disk is 2150400, and the number of byte stored per sector is 512. Okay, so how we will know about the number of sector? So here the byte stored per sector, here 512 is the byte stored per sector. When we multiply this byte with the number of sector, okay, total byte stored is 215. Here number of byte per sector is 512, and multiplied by number of sector, total number of sector in a disk, equals to how much data is stored? 215 2150 400. Okay, 21500. So here in this way we can calculate the number of sector. So total number of sectors in a disk in both side, because it has two side in both side, is equal to 42000. So these are the number of sector.
So here what we need to calculate, determine the number of sector per track for the hard disk. We have to calculate sector per track. Okay, so number of sector per track. So here we know number of sectors are this one. Sector is 42000 per track. So total number of track, how many total number of track there are? 1200. Okay, so this will come equals to 35. So 35 number of sector present in each track. Okay, so in first track there are 35 sector, in second track there are 35 sector. So this is the way how we calculate the answer of related to track and sector. So friends, if you like this video, please subscribe, and thank you for watching my video. Thanks once again.